Hey guys, today I'm really excited. Today I'll be helping you build your first website. It could be on any niche, whatever you like, whatever you are passionate about. It could be guitar, food, technology, anything. Just make sure you watch the video till the end because we have a special bonus gift for you.
Hey guys, welcome to the Digital Marketing Mastery course. And today's video is really exciting and honestly the most important video of this entire course. In the last lesson, I gave you an overview that why starting a blog is one of the most important steps in your journey to become a good digital marketer. In my own journey of this 7 plus years of doing digital marketing, I have never learned a trade just by reading about it or watching a video about it. Unless and until I practice it, I'm not able to learn the skill. So even today, whenever a new tool comes up or whenever a new technique of doing digital marketing comes up, I always make sure that I do it by hand. Digital marketing is not something that you can learn just by looking at theory or watching videos. Unless and until you're implementing the tactics, you won't be able to. So whenever you're building a blog, the first thing that you need to know is a domain name. What is a domain name? A domain name is your website name. A domain name is the address where internet users can access your website. Like the case of Facebook. Now Facebook.com is the domain name for the company Facebook. Similarly, Google.com is the domain name for the company Google. I know it's very simple, but still I'm explaining it for people who don't know it. Now, there can be multiple extensions of your domain name. The popular ones are .com definitely, like google.com, facebook.com, instagram.com. .com is suited more for the international audience, but when you're targeting specific countries, like if we take the case of India, if you want to target only the Indian audience, then instead of going for .com, you can go for .in. Like my case, my website address is ankuraggarwal.in. Because my primary audience will be Indian audience, that is why I didn't go for a .com, but rather went for a .in domain. Now, after the domain name, to start a blog, you need a hosting. What is a web hosting? Now, web hosting is a service that allows organizations and individuals to post a website or a web page on the internet. So, just like you have almirahs and cupboards to store your stuff, similarly, your website also needs a place to store all the files and the folders. A website is nothing but a directory of files and various folders that are rendered over a server over a particular domain name. So whenever you're thinking of starting a blog, you need two things. First is the domain name and second is the website hosting. Now hosting also comes in different varieties. So there's a shared web hosting, cloud hosting, and then there is dedicated hosting. So let me explain each of them to you. So we shall start with the shared web hosting. Now, shared hosting is a type of web hosting that allows multiple websites to share a physical web server and its resources among the hosted websites. So whenever you're buying a web hosting, you're actually buying the space of the various servers. So there are various companies that sell web hosting like SiteGround, GoDaddy, Bluehost, HostGator. So whenever you're buying a hosting, you're actually buying some space on the server of this company. So these companies have massive servers, so you're actually paying a monthly fees for some space on these servers. So when we talk about shared web hosting, you're actually taking a small part of the server. Because taking the entire server will be really expensive, so shared web hosting is a solution for people to start their blog at a very cheap price by taking a small part of the server. So by introducing this concept of shared hosting, multiple websites can run on the same server. And also shared hosting is the cheapest option. So to understand this clearly, let's take an example. So let's assume that you're looking for a flat and you have seen this flat which is really amazing and it has 3 rooms. But your requirement is only for 1 room. So you wouldn't want to pay for the entire flat when you only need 1 room, right? So the solution is that 3 people can take 1 room each so that each person doesn't have to pay the entire amount of the flat, rather just 1/3 of the entire rent. So that's how shared web hosting works. So that's how shared web hosting works. A server has multiple websites and they pay a small fees just to have some part of the server usage. And this is what you will be purchasing to start your blog as well, because this is the cheapest option. And also for beginners or people who are just starting out with digital marketing or with starting a blog, a shared web hosting is more than enough because you're not driving a huge amount of traffic because you're just starting out. Now the next comes the cloud hosting. This is the one I use because my website is driving approximately 12 lakh people per month, and to handle such kind of traffic you need a good server, and that is why I am paying a premium for the server and I'm also using cloud hosting. Now cloud hosting services provide hostings on virtual servers which pull their computing resource from extensive underlying networks of physical web servers. Now just like I told you that cloud hosting is used by established websites that are driving a massive traffic. And because it is costlier as well, so startup people or people who are just starting out with digital marketing or starting out blogging, they should not consider it. Right now I'm paying approximately $120 per month just for my cloud hosting, whereas in shared hosting you will only be paying approximately $3 to $4 per month. In cloud hosting, your files are hosted in a cloud server. Now, dedicated hosting is for the extremely popular website that are driving millions of people on a monthly basis, and they need that kind of server resources. So this is when dedicated hosting comes into play. So websites like facebook.com, google.com, instagram.com, or even very big popular websites which are driving multi-million people per month, they need to go for dedicated hosting. In dedicated hosting, instead of sharing the server with multiple websites, you own the entire server. So you own all the resources. And also, dedicated hosting is quite complex, so you really cannot, as a beginner, cannot manage it. You will need to hire a server person who will be handling the entire server. But dedicated hostings are extremely fast and can handle enormous traffic just because you're not sharing the space with anyone else. So people who are just starting out or individual bloggers, dedicated hosting is not the solution. It is more for big businesses. So these are the three types of hosting. Now let's talk about free hosting. Especially in India, free is something that is really preferred. And people think, why pay for hosting when you can get everything for free? But you have to understand one thing, that nothing good is free in this world. Yes, free hosting does exist, but they have their limitations, they have a lot of drawbacks, and honestly, they are not worth it. If you are starting this digital marketing journey, then you'll have to invest some money in a paid hosting, because as I said, that the only way to learn digital marketing is through practical knowledge. And these free web hosting providers, they are honestly very shitty. They have limited server resources, they have unstable performances, that means your website will go blank or will give 404 error even with small traffic. And the worst part is, there will be no technical support. Since you are starting out your blogging, sooner or later you will face issues. You will face problems like installing WordPress or some plugin is not working. Then you need someone to talk to. That's where the web hosting company comes into play. There are support people, you can directly call them or live chat with them, and they will solve the issue for you. But with free hosting, nothing like that comes. But with free hosting, there is no technical support. And also in my experiences, I have seen that free hosting scams are also going on, where they will offer you free hosting for a month or two, but you won't even realize after 2 months or maybe 3 months or even 4 months, they'll charge you a huge renewal fee. So personally, I would recommend you to stay away from free hosting and rather just invest few dollars in a paid hosting plan. Since you're investing your time and energy in learning digital marketing, and with my 7 plus years of digital marketing experience, the one recommendation that I can give you is just invest few dollars in this paid hosting plan, and this step alone will give you a huge push in becoming a very good digital marketer. So the good things about paid hostings are that you get unlimited space, unlimited bandwidth, and email account. So with unlimited space and unlimited bandwidth, you can drive as many people as possible. Yes, there's an upper limit of around 10 to 20,000 visitors per day. But if you're just starting out, that is more than enough. Also with paid hosting plan, there are so many benefits. Instead of knowing the technicalities behind installing WordPress and all, which we will be talking about in the next lesson, there's one-click installation. All you have to do is just click on a couple of icons and almost everything will be installed automatically. And also there's a money-back guarantee. If you're not happy with the hosting, you can directly call the company and they will refund you your money. And the most important reason for going for a paid blog hosting is the experienced support staff. I can't tell you how important it is. Even today, after opening approximately 50 plus blogs, sites, and even working on my client's website, still today we face some kind of an issue. So the one thing that we do is go to the support staff and tell them our query. And they are the one that helped me out, and they are the one that fixed the issue. There have been multiple instances where my website was hacked, and it was the support staff that helped me out. It was the support staff that helped me get my website back, helped me get my revenue back. And also, paid hostings used to be expensive earlier. Now they are extremely cheap. And also, if you follow this course correctly and if you start a blog like the way I tell you, within few months you'll be making a good amount of income as a passive source of income. So the money that you're investing in your blog is, don't take it as an expense, but rather an investment that will be giving you benefits later. So I've already shared why paid hosting is recommended and why it is one of the most important steps for you to learn digital marketing. So the hosting company I recommend is definitely SiteGround. This is the company that I am using. This is the company where all my websites are hosted. And honestly, I've tried almost every hosting company out there, be it GoDaddy, be it HostGator, be it Bluehost, and almost all of them, be it A2 Hosting, etc, etc. But my search ended at SiteGround, the website. This hosting company is phenomenal. And I think their plus point is their support staff. They are so knowledgeable and they solve the queries so quickly. And there are so many reasons why SiteGround is recommended open. Here I've listed all the reasons why I recommend SiteGround and why SiteGround is the number one choice for any person who is thinking of starting a blog. I know in India specifically, GoDaddy also does TV commercials and they have a huge marketing budget. So you'll see advertisements of GoDaddy all over the internet. But trust me, I have never seen a worst hosting like GoDaddy. A couple of years ago, my websites were on GoDaddy and trust me, they are pathetic. I still remember I used to wait 30 to 40 minutes just to solve a support query on the phone, just waiting for the customer care to actually take my call. The website was sluggish and they were not even able to handle the kind of traffic that I was getting. So make sure you read this entire article till the end, why I recommend SiteGround. And you will know for yourself that this is definitely the best hosting provider right now as of 2019, by now. So there are three different plans here. So there's a startup plan, there's a grow big plan, and there's a go geek plan. Let me first differentiate between each of them. So startup plan is the cheapest plan, but the only drawback is that you can only host one website on this plan. And also there's a limit of 10,000 visitors per month. The difference between a startup and a grow big plan is that you can host unlimited websites. So even in the future, if you think of creating a new website for you, for your friend, or just a new idea that might come into your mind, or maybe you want to start a startup and you need a website for that, then you can go for a GrowBig plan. And also this is the one that I will recommend to you guys, because I've seen that the GrowBig plan is extremely fast. The hosting is really fast. So your website will load at lightning speed. And I've seen that whenever someone starts the journey of becoming a digital marketer, they end up making multiple websites. So whenever someone goes for the startup plan, they end up regretting that they need to create more websites and they can't do it. So I will recommend go for the GrowBig plan. So I'll be buying this one. So let's click on get plan. I forgot to differentiate between this one. So the GoGeek and the GrowBig, the only primary difference is the traffic. So GoGeek plan can handle a huge amount of traffic. Although they say that they can handle 100,000 visitors per month, but my website, when it was not reaching 1.2 million visitors, even at 300,000 visitors, this GoGeek plan was giving me no issues at all. It was my personal choice that I went to the cloud hosting. But even at 300,000 to 500,000, this plan is perfect for you. But since you guys are just starting out, I'll recommend GrowBig plan. So let's create a website in this. So register a new domain, or I already have a domain. So we will be registering a new domain. Ask Ankur. Let's ask Ankur.in. Domain registration is extra. So let's click proceed. So I'll fill in all the information here. So guys, I'll fill all the information here. And so I'll pause the video and then play it again. So guys, I have filled up all the details above, on like the addresses, the card details and all. So let's look at all the other options SiteGround provides. So the plan is GrowBig, and the data center is Singapore. So data center is the place where all your files will be stored. So SiteGround gives you multiple options: Chicago, Amsterdam, London, Iowa, Singapore. So if you're creating a website that is targeting Indian audience, then go for Singapore, because the closer your server is to your target audience, the better it is for you, the faster your website will load. So if you're creating a website that is targeting the audience of the US, then you can go for Chicago or Iowa, because that is much closer to USA compared to Singapore. For the period, I will recommend you to go for 12 months, because if you go for 1 month, the renewal price will be $19.95. I won't recommend you to go for the trial account, because you'll be paying much more money, just $24 just for the setup, and also the renewal price will be $20, $19.95 per month. So if you go for 12 month plan or even 24 month plan, you'll get the benefit of this discounted price. And you are being offered this discounted price because you're going from MyLink. So we have this partnership with SiteGround. So I will recommend you to go for 12 month or even 24 months. But minimum 12 month. Don't go for the trial 1 month, else you will just end up wasting your money. Yes, we need the domain registration as well. SG Site Scanner is something I won't recommend you to have it. It's not mandatory. So we won't be taking that. So I confirm I would like to receive SiteGround news and special offers by email. Okay, I will take that and I'll click pay now. So guys, my order was successful. I purchased this hosting. So guys, this is how you buy a domain name and a hosting for yourself. In the next lesson, we will be telling you how to set up your blog like a pro. So whenever people buy a hosting or a domain name, they make the big mistake of not setting up their blog correctly. And in my experience, I have set up approximately 500 plus websites. So I know exactly what works and what doesn't. How to configure your website in the most perfect way. So make sure you watch the next lesson till the end as well. Your blog, and my congratulations to all of you, because you are starting your own blog now. I'm feeling really excited because I'll be helping you out, build your blog, add content to your blog, and learn everything about digital marketing. And not just that, I'll also help you monetize your blog, how to make money from your blog. Everything will be discussed in this digital marketing course, and not just digital marketing course. Make sure you share the URL of your blog on Facebook group as well. I want my Facebook group to be the most active group of Facebook. So make sure you ask questions, your doubts, any concern, and also attend all the Facebook lives because I answer all your questions. So guys, I'll see you in the next lesson where I'll tell you how to set up your blog like a professional blogger.
Hey guys, I hope you understood the simple process of starting a website from scratch. In the next video, we'll be going into the technical details, the settings, the configurations, but worry not, it's all simple. And I will be showing you everything on screen. If you have any question, any query, feel free to ask it in our Facebook group. You can also tweet us at #AskAnkur and I'll be answering your queries. I'll see you in the next video.